we chat with Sean Sloan from PIRSA about Windara Reef.
Now tell us about this Windara Reef that you've just constructed here.
We started off with the idea to enhance recreational fishing opportunities in the state. What we wanted to do was not just build something that would attract fish and make them easier to catch and potentially put our fish stocks under more pressure, but to actually enhance the habitat that could help actually build our fish stocks over time. So we partnered up with an international environmental NGO, the Nature Conservancy, as well as Recfish SA, the local council here and the Adelaide Uni, and built a partnership to essentially do what the Nature Conservancy had done in the US to restore native oyster reefs. And we've built the basic infrastructure now. There's about 800 tonnes of limestone that's been laid in rows. There's also about 60 purpose-built concrete structures that are actually designed to build the basis of the infrastructure for these native oyster reefs. So once the native oysters are seated on the reef, that's when the ecosystem starts to get built, and we would expect that they take about 18 months to 2 years to mature, and that's when all the marine life will get attracted and the ecosystem will start functioning.
So how long would it take to get back to perhaps what it was 100 or so years ago?
This is really going to be a blueprint for what we would like to see replicated in other parts of the state. So this will be a 20 hectare site when it's finished. There was about 1,500 kilometres of coastline that was characterised by this native oyster shellfish reef. By improving the habitat, we will over time improve fish stocks. This site here will be a recreational fishing reef. So we've probably got a long way to go, but certainly a good start. But of course, everybody benefits. Commercial fishers benefit as well, because as our fish stocks are improved, everybody will actually reap the benefits of having more fish in the system.
And sort of out here in the Gulf, there's King George Whiting and there's squid and there's snapper. What sort of fish do you think will come to this reef?
Well, when you create the habitat that provides food for fish, shelter, we would expect it to be a nursery ground for some of the smaller fish. So all of those species that you mentioned, even probably snapper, blue crabs, all those species would find a home here, and also potentially become an attractive spawning ground for some species as well.
Now my final question, the name Windara, where did that come from?
Windara Reef was chosen by the local school kids over this way, and it's basically the Aboriginal name for the eastern side of the York Peninsula.
Didn't know that. And what a wonderful ownership those kids will have of that as they grow and become adults and use the area.
Yeah,
to think they had something to do with it.
It's a
great thing.
It's a terrific initiative overall, and we've been overwhelmed by the support we've had from everybody.